All right, so we are here on Pure Country with the beautiful Madeline Merlo.
Hello,
how are things?
Things are so good. How are you doing?
I'm good. I feel like you are in a very exciting time right now with this song out. Did you think Dear Me was going to blow up like it has?
No, I didn't even think it was going to be a single. Like when I wrote it, I knew I really loved it. I really loved it. And I kept going back to the demo and listening to it. And, but I thought it was like maybe an album, deep album kind of.
Really?
It felt so personal to me. And I was like, I don't know, like if other people would be, like this would resonate with them. But, my label loved it. And we kind of souped it up and went to the studio. And I'm so, so happy with how it turned out. Like, I love it so much.
Like an anthem now, which I feel like is kind of a cool thing, especially for your first one out of the gate for new music.
Yeah.
So is that any kind of indication of what is to come from you?
Yeah, I think that the next project is just really honest songwriting, and I feel sonically as well with that song, it feels really like I'm getting onto, you know, my sound and something that really feels 100% me, which is hard to do sometimes.
Yeah, I mean, and it's a lot to be that honest, you know, when you're doing your songwriting, like letting people write in.
For sure, for sure. And that day too, I wrote that song on Belle Let's Talk Day, and it was that day is always a bit heavy for me because, you know, I have anxiety. It's just a lot anxiety vibes, and we just wrote that song like first line to last line, and it just kind of like poured out of us.
So I feel like that's a big day for you because War Paint kind of became the anthem for that. A lot of people I know reach out to you on that day.
Yeah, exactly. And it's so special. I'm so glad. But it is all day, you know, these people's stories, and it can become a lot sometimes.
So what was that writing session like? Did you have the Dear Me idea when you went into it, like I want to write a letter to myself kind of idea, or what was the approach in that writing session?
It was cool because it just happened. We were on a completely other idea, and we weren't feeling inspired by it. I even forget like what the idea was. I think we had maybe that kind of climbing melody in the chorus, and then Abram Dean, one of the co-writers, he just started playing that like bow, 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 bow. And I think I was like, Dear Me, and we all kind of looked at each other and we're like, and then we made a joke, Dear Meat. That's how it started, I think, actually.
Glad we turned it just into Dear Meat. And that could have been a fun song, too,
different
though.
Different song.
So the video just came out for it. It is amazing.
Thank you so much.
The little girl who plays Minnie Madeline is the cutest thing I've ever seen.
Her name's Alice, and she just crushed it. And she's 5.
She knows every word.
Yeah, and she had this incredible spirit about her, and she reminded, my mom was like, it's spooky how much you guys are similar, and she was just so special, like a really special kid.
Is that the first time you had met her on set?
No, so my best friend is an acting agent, and that's her client, and so like a year and a half ago, I sent Alice a message, because she loves War Paint, and I was like, hi Alice, I'm Madeline, like thanks for being a fan, and so Alice knew who I was and everything, so she was really excited when I was like, do you want to play Little Me? And she was like, what?
You could tell in the video that she was having the best time.
She really was. She was
so
special.
Whose idea was it to do that kind of idea for the video as far as the concept goes of having a mini Madeline?
Yeah, that was like initially, like after we decided that was going to be the single, I knew, even writing it, I was like, there needs to be like an inner child, inner me, because I feel like that's like really the most innocent part of yourself, and it's so powerful to have, like, I don't know. I think about little Madeline a lot, and hope that I like do her proud and things like that. And so I needed that message to be across, and I needed it to be in BC. I wanted it to feel like the place that I grew up in. And then Stefano is an incredible. He's won like CCMA video director review like 1,000 times. So my odds are with me this year.
Yeah, he's pretty much the king of videos.
Yeah, and so I was like, you know, I really want a little Madeline. I really want it to be here. And I just want it to feel like cinematic and powerful and beautiful. And he did.
You did it. It worked.
Yeah,
so,
thank you.
Another little detail that I know he posted about but I think is cool to watch for in the video is the cape that she's wearing.
Yes.
With the Wonder Woman logo upside down.
It's an
for
M.
MM.
Mm-hmm.
So that
amazing.
Was Stefano's idea?
Yeah, okay. So he's so talented. And he just knew immediately like what I wanted to accomplish. And I wanted it to feel sweet, but I wanted it to feel like sexy and powerful at the same time and to have that kind of combination, which I think he just nailed.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So I have to ask you about your socials. So when you were getting ready to announce Dear Me, you went like blackout.
Yeah.
Everything disappeared.
Blackout.
I was like, where did she go?
Yeah.
And then you went through and kind of like cleaned up through your socials and just have
I think I have like 38 posts now.
Yeah. So was that your choice to do that? Or
We have like kind of a social media person at the label, and we had just talked about it. And I just wanted my page to feel really music focused. And I didn't want them to know. I just needed them to come to my page. And everyone's like, she's a musician. She's not an influencer. She's not anything else. It's just music. And felt like this was like a new chapter in my life. And it was like kind of a crazy season of life. And come out fresh, and I thought I would be more stressed out about doing it, but it felt really good. Yeah. I was like, bye. Like,
social media cleanse.
Yeah, it was amazing.
I think more people should probably do that.
I think so too. Yeah.
So a few little questions about the song as far as the lyrics go. You talk about drinking water in it. What is your go-to water that you drink? Like if you're gonna buy some water.
I like Voss water. Okay. I like try to like stay away from plastics. Yeah, so I try to do
She's
that.
She's an environmentally friendly girl.
Yeah, but or like if that's not an option, I like Evian too.
Okay. So if you say in there that you're your father's daughter, but you've got your mom's eyes, do you actually have your mom's eyes?
Yeah,
you do?
Yes, absolutely.
Who are you more like, mom or dad?
Ooh, I think I'm kind of a good combination. My dad is just like he's a smart guy. If he decided to build a motorcycle, and he built a motorcycle, and he just is like one of those people. Is a really, really special brain. And my mom is just like very sweet. So I feel like I kind of got like good things for both of them. Not like I could build a motorsacle or anything, but very like marketing brain, like business mindset. And then my mom is just like a sweet little bird,
She just
loves people so hard. It's really special.
And last one. So you talk obviously a lot about anxiety in there. What's your favorite way to kind of help yourself deal with anxiety if you're having a bad day?
Oh yeah. I think that it's, for me, it's a lot of like precautionary stuff. Like I make a really big effort to start my day off in a right, like I meditate every morning and I do the, and I have to go to yoga. That's the one thing. Yeah. If I feel like really anxious, I need to go there or call my mom, or there's like, I have like a list of things that I can do, you know? But I think if you start your day off, like, you know, I try not to get to that place at all.
I like that. Yeah. Okay, cool. Mm-hmm. Well, if you haven't seen the video for Dear Me, make sure you check it out and listen to the song Madeline Merlo on Pure Country.